God, by your grace
and prayers, be
remembering our awful need, your most blessed and glorious name, that they are always and ever preparing with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves, O God, and our whole life unto Christ our God.
In you, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Again,
peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us save. all the saints, have mercy on us and protect us, O God, by your grace. Remembering your own holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious name, we pray with all the servants of your grace. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves, O Lord, in our whole life, unto Christ our God.
Through you,
our
Lord.
For blessed is your all holy name, and glorified is your kingdom, of the Father, of the Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Yeah. sprinkle with hyssop, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I will be made whiter than snow. You shall make me your joy, and gladness. My bones that were humbled shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit. O teach transgressions your ways, and the body shall turn back to you. Renew me from my guiltiness about the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, my mouth, and my praise. For if you desire sacrifice, I will give it. You will not be pleased with hope and offerings. Sacrifice to God with a broken spirit, a broken and humble heart, God, will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Zion, and let the walls of your truth be built. Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings, with hope and offerings. Then shall it offer down bulls on your altar.
Glory to the Father and the Son.
God, save your people and bless your inheritance. Look upon your world with mercy and compassion. Pray to praise the Orthodox Christians in glory and shout out to your abundant mercies. In the intercessions of our most pure lady, the fair Pope, and ever Virgin Mary, by the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable body of the flowers of heaven, supplication of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner, John the Baptist, of the most glorious and praiseworthy apostles and our fathers among the saints and very arts and ecumenical teachers. The praise of the great Gregory the theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Sincero, John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexander, Nicholas, Bishop of Myra, and Nicias, Spirit, Bishop of Phoenicus, Nicodius, Nicopolis, John Maximus, Bishop of Shanghai, San Francisco, Seraphim of Sarov, and other workers, of the Holy Glorious Great Martyrs, Lord, Victorious Creatures, the Merciful, Theater of the Recruit, Theater of the Commander, Minas, the Wonder Worker, Adalbus, and Athabius, the Priest Martyrs, the Holy Glorious Great Martyr, the Law of Bohemia, the Holy Glorious Martyrs, the Echo Barbaras, the C.A. Catherine, P.A.T., Fortini, Martin, Hunsky, B.A. Rain, Martin, Theos. Of the Holy Glorious and Victorious Martyrs, of the Venerable Godly Said Father, of the Holy Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the commemoration, of the Holy Protecting Veil, of the Theotokos, the commemoration and thanksgiving of which we keep today, and of all your saints, we beseech you, Holy Merciful Lord, hear us sinners who pray to you and have mercy on us.
Protect and save your people who cry out to you, pure. flame, garments, torches, and fuel. In the memory of our beloved father, Saint Athanasius, patriarch of Constantinople, who struggled against asceticism and apostles. The memory of the holy four new martyrs, Angelos, Emmanuel, George, and Nicholas, who witnessed in Lampus of the North Crete. On this day, we commemorate the memory of the protection of the all holy lady, the Theotokos, and the ever Virgin Mary, who has always and especially protects our faithful nation, as in times of old she protected the queen of cities. By the intercession of your blameless mother, Christ God, have mercy on you. And guard us back from visible and invisible enemies and save our souls. Amen.
Thank you.
And angels singing the presenting day of the Mother of God, where a man sit down in protection, say those who trust in it, the dew which falls in drops from your godly protection, as from an immortal blood, O immaculate, becomes healing for us and brings humanity into soul and body for those who cry.
the ever virgin maiden, and her mother of God, ally and protection of the attack, and above all refuge and ready help, let us all praise as is fitting, as we magnify her
to the ages of man.
Let your mercy be on
Suffering the captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. sacraments, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our all holy pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, to the Theotokos and her Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Mares divas unisas, ex dexion su, que imagino, via Cristo peribemeni, peripipimeni. Τίγατρος, η βασιλέως έσωστε. Ο πρόσωπον σου ήταν έσωση η πλούση του λαού σου.
Thank you.
estati che sia a foto di amatio su.
Per i siepus ai vani.
thanks to you we offer glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Είναι η δεύτερη σωμόνη Μάρτα, βεβαίω αυτό αφορεί στον οίκο αυτή.
της και τη δανή αδελφή καλημέρι Μαρία ή και παρακαθίσασα παρά, παρά τους πόδους του Ιησού ήχουε το λόγο αυτού. Είδε Μάρθα περισπάτω περί πολλή διακονία επιστάσα δε είπε Κύριε μου μέλησή ότι η δελφή μου ημέν κατέληκα διακονή είπε ου αυτή είναι ανήξη να τη λάβητε. Αποκριτής δε είπε αυτή ο Ιησούς Μάρθα, Μάρθα, μερινάς και τυρφάζει περί πολλά ενώτες κυκρία Μαρία δε διακατή τη μερίδα εξελέξατο ή της που αφαιρεθήσετε απ' αυτής διέντοτε έτη εν το λέγει από τάφτα έπερσα επαραστά της γυνή φωνή εκ του όπου είπεν αυτό Μακαρία η Κυρία ημάς τάσα σας και μας τύχους ευθύνα σας. Αυτό δε, αυτός δε είπε με νούνιε, μακάρι, μακάρι οι οκούσεντες το λόγο του Θεού και φυλάσσοντες αυτό. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Luke, let us be attentive. At that time Jesus entered a village, and a woman called Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she went to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve you alone? Tell her then to help me. But the Lord answered her, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. One thing is needful, Mary has chosen a good portion, which shall not be taken away from her. As he said this, a woman in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, Blessed is the womb that bore you in the breast that you stopped. But he said, Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and keep it.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is in our midst. It is good for us to gather, brothers and sisters in Christ, and to allow ourselves to be affected. Let our time be affected. Let our souls be affected. Let our minds and our hearts be affected by the call of the church that calls us together for worship. It's good for that to happen. It's good for us to take time out of our lives to allow for yet another divine liturgy to impact our lives. And, you know, we may say, okay, you know, 90% of this divine liturgy is identical to every other divine liturgy, so why is this day special? Now, of course, you who are here know why it's special. It's not just because the priest says so. It is special because we have allowed the church to dictate our time. We have allowed the church to dictate our lives. We have allowed the church to affect us in such a way where we cannot be but here. And yes, we have choices, but the choice of the matter is that we need to be in the sanctuary of the Lord. And we have made that decision. Maybe we were asked, maybe it was on the schedule, maybe whatever the reason, but we are here. And that seems not very profound to say. Seems very obvious. But yet, our presence here today is exactly why we celebrate this feast. It's the whole point. Being present in the company and in the presence of the Lord, being awake at the time of the coming of the divine, being, allowing ourselves to be called, whatever the reason, into the sanctuary of the Lord is exactly what the Feast of Holy Protection is really about. Because we can say, okay, well, you know, Panagia is protecting us. That's why we have Holy Day. That's why we moved it from the 1st of October when everything was originally celebrated, and still is, to among the Greeks, the celebration of this and the thanksgiving of this feast is done today to represent how we were protected by Panagia, you know, against the forces of Mussolini and the Axis powers of World War II. And that's all good. It's all well and good. And that is very important for us to understand in our heritage as we are closely connected, not too far away, less than 100 years, that we're still doing this, that we're still remembering what took place at Oki Day, the day where the phrase was coined by Churchill Greeks do not fight like heroes. Heroes fight like Greeks. You know, and this is, you know, you get chills thinking about things like this. But at the same time, and as much as that is important to understand, and as much as it's, very beneficial for us to remember this past, we don't, in the church, remember the past just for the sake of the past. We don't do that. We don't keep memorials so that we can, you know, oh, the good old days. That's not what the church is. The church is not a memorial or a museum of that which has already taken place in our lives. The church is a present reality. The church is alive and well. And regardless of whether Mussolini comes back from the dead or not, we have things that we have to watch out for. We have enemies in our lives that we have to focus on, and not focus on the enemies, but focus on our protection against them. And that's what Agnus Dei is about. That's what it's about. It's Panagia's protection, asking for the Lord to protect us. Through her, he uses her to protect us from all kinds of dangers and ills and sicknesses and calamities and wars, and all kinds of stuff that we have to go through. So many times we can say, oh, it was our angel, or it was this, or it was that. Well, a lot of times, a lot of those angels and things that come through our protection and we praise God for, and we worship our Lord for, come through the hands of the Panagia. It just does. You know, we can't change how God uses her to affect our lives. We just can't change. As they say in the South, it's what is. It's what is. Rather than to deny it, rather than to say, well, she's not that important. Yes, she is that important, because God keeps using her. If you've got a person that God has used for the last 2,000 years to bring cognizance of mind and worship of Christ to the world, she's darn important. We've got evidence proving it. So she's not just some person. And her protection is not just some protection. Outside of Christ, it's the only protection we need. That's it. And her protection is the one that leads us to Christ. She's not done. She doesn't want us to stop at her. She wants us to get to him. That's why she's constantly pointing the way. Every icon you see, her hand is leading the way right to Jesus. Even when he's up on the cross, she's looking up at him. Her eyes are not turned away the way you would think a mother's would. Seeing her son dying, her eyes are not turned away from him. Her even in the most grotesque portion of his life, she is still leading us and looking at him. But none of that is as important as being here today. Why? Excuse me. Because we would not have this feast if it wasn't for the liturgy. This feast that we celebrate today, October 1st, more than a millennium ago, we would not have if it was not for the divine liturgy. Because it was during the divine liturgy that she appeared. It was during the celebration of the Eucharist that we are about to continue to celebrate in bringing the Eucharist before us and offering it and placing it on the table. It was during that celebration that St. Andrew the Fool for Christ saw and witnessed her coming into the church, taking off her veil, and shielding it and shrouding it over the congregation like a protection. It's his witness, as he was describing this to one of his disciples that was following him around. This man was a fool for Christ. It was crazy. He was doing a whole lot of things that people were like, he's nuts. They didn't have the same disciples like that. They just let him out on the streets, They would lock some people up once in a while, but you can't keep them locked up forever. Not just for being crazy. He wasn't breaking laws, he was just driving people nuts. And this is what he saw. He saw her walking out larger than life. And her veil was outstretched. And as he's dictating this towards his disciple, and when it came time for communion, he saw her lift up the veil so that, because it was just over the nave. It wasn't for the altar. He saw her lift up her veil so that people could walk out, receive communion, and then when they came back, receiving Christ, they would be perfection, right? And then as soon as they come back out from here, so this, remember, what does the nave represent? Earth. What does the altar represent? Heaven. What does this soleil represent? The place where earth meets heaven. So here you're good, there you're good, here we're in trouble. Her protection was over the people. They came, she lifted up her veil so that they could come for a communion, and then she lifted it back up again so that they could come back underneath her protection. This happened during the Eucharistic service, during the Divine Liturgy, during that portion of the Divine Liturgy, which was so important for us to be protected. Not that we need to be protected in church necessarily, but it was important as a witness. So the Divine Liturgy, and more important than just the Divine Liturgy, if you have a Divine Liturgy with nobody there, can you have one? You can't. So your presence, our presence, humanity's presence at the Divine Liturgy is imperative. It's not just, this is nice. You can't do it. Without the people's presence in the Divine Liturgy, there is no liturgy. Without St. Andrew the Fool for Christ and the church that was filled, there would not be the Feast of the Holy Protection. We wouldn't have seen it. We wouldn't have been around it. We have to keep these things in mind. These are things that we're not, again, this is not something that we're remembering, something that happened with Mussolini, less than 100 years ago. And we're not simply remembering something that happened in the church, I think it was of Vacherna, more than 1,000 years ago. The things and the ideas of the church are a present reality for us. What is the meaning, of course? It's for us to always be in the Lord's presence as often as we can. Because only in the Lord's presence can we be protected. And it's not something saying, well, God, you do your job, I'll do mine. He who is everywhere present and filling all things, you do your job. That's what the world says. That's what they do. They accuse God of not doing his job. That's what they're saying. Whenever they say, why would a loving God allow for all this evil to exist? That's what they're saying. They're accusing God.
saying, we are guilty of it as well if we fall into this like mindset. That's not the place that we stand. We don't stand on the judgment seat against God. We stand in the accusatory seat against the judge who has more than enough to charge us. Justifiably and fairly. We stand in the presence of God. And they ought, the more, most often that we come before the presence of God, both in the sanctuary and outside of the sanctuary, the more under His protection we are. That's what this feast is about. It's for us allowing the church to call us together. It's for us allowing the church to come. Because when that happens, when we come together, that's where the miracle is. It's not by our nature. Actually, it kind of is by our nature that we should gather. But also, in our nature, is the defiance that says, there's other things I should do. So today, it's a good thing that we are here, in whatever capacity, in whatever number, doesn't matter. It's good that we are here to grow this show. And we have to continue to gather in the presence of God. Because in that presence, we are safe. Safe from barbarians? No. You know, barbarians have their free will as well. Now we're safe from a bigger enemy. One that's going to not just try to take away our lives, but it's going to try to take our eternal life from us. Amen? For that, we should say, right. For that, may the protection and blessings of the Mother of God, who has spread veil and continues to protect us, be with us and lead us to Christ, so that we can always be in His presence this day and all days. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, that ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. To the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us complete our prayer to the Lord. For the precious gifts you have presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it, with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the Lord. Ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life creative Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And your spirit.
Let us love her that with one mind we may
Western our heart and disease, the God of the Lord, who is here, the loss of the Savior, the opposite of the Father, the loss of the least of the humans, the best of the people, the least of the best of the muscles, the world, and the least of the muscles.
Ότι σου έστει βασιλεία και δύναμις και δόξα, του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, νυν και αεί, και εις αιώνας των αιώνων. Ειρήνη πάση,
ας
και παλάσιμον, το πεδίο κλείνομαι. Therefore, Master, it's new and beneficial for us all that lies ahead according to the English. Sail for us to sail, travel for us to travel, and seek the position of our soul and bodies. By the grace, mercy, and compassion, and love for our mankind, your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Sanctify us, you who are enthroned with the Father and high in all, and are present among us that is in the air. With your mighty hand, grant communion of the most pure body and precious blood to us, and for us to all people. Let us be attentive, the holy gifts, for the holy people of God. Aia Tisaiis, Shetaia Shati, Los Santos para Los Santos.
Nor will I give you kisses to Judas, that I speak, I confess to you, Lord, remember.
Sos notas palamsu, carefully from the Kuramiansu. O God, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Rostislav, the great Lumen, the Duke of
Lord, aid the members we can remember today, and of all the saints of mercy, and of the saved, praise you, merciful God, who loves mankind, through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, the God, have mercy on us, and save us. May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep all of you. May the blessing and holy protection of the Theotokos be with you now and forever. God bless you again for being here and for offering your time and for letting the church call you. Our next service, of course, will be Sunday. And as a preliminary, I'm just reminding everyone that I am going away starting Monday till Wednesday for the Archdiocesan Presbyters Council that will be taking place in Virginia. The national conferences of the clergy happen every 2 years. They happen once a year, but it depends on when. So they happen in the fall every 2 years, and then they happen at the national national clergy retreat in the fall, and then they happen at the national clergy lady on the off years. So we are going down to prepare ourselves for the coming meeting that will happen next fall. And thank you with your prayers. It's good to travel.
Son, O you who gave birth to the true light, enlighten the eyes of understanding of my heart. O you who gave birth to the fountain of immortality, and love me, O dead by sin. Love our hearts, and mother of the mercy of God. Have mercy on me, and give me repentance and contrition of heart. Humility, my thoughts, and recall my instincts and servitude. Count me to my last breath, worthy to receive. Count me to my last breath to receive the sanctification of the most pure mysteries, for healing of soul and body. Give me tears of repentance and confession, O Lady, that I may praise and glorify all the days of my life. Your blessed, great, and glorified forever. Amen.
Your blessed, glorified in the ages. Amen.
Your blessed, great, and glorified forever. Amen.
Ask me, let me serve and depart in peace according to your word, and ask to see your salvation, which you have prepared before the presence of all people, the light of life and Gentiles, and the glory of the first world.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now there to the ages. Ages. Amen. The Most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse away our sins. The Master, forgive our iniquities. All the ones that sit in your perfect peace, for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For that is the kingdom and the power of the Lord, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen. Receive the praise of your grace, O you, your protecting veil, Virgin, which like a light-bearing cloud you unfold beyond understanding, and you spiritually protect your people from every assault of their foe. For we have gained you as a protection and defender and helper as we cry out to you. Glory to your mighty deeds, O pure one. Glory to your protection. Glory to your providence towards us, O Immaculate.
Yes.
Mother of God, ever protection, ever virgin, you have given your holy protection through which you protect those who hope in you as a mighty refuge for your faith, for your race, for you, for as of old, so now you have wondrously saved, enveloping your people with a spiritual cloud. And so we implore you to grant peace to your commonwealth and to our soul's great mercy. Grace shining forth from your lips like a beacon as in light universe, shown to the world the riches of poverty, it has revealed us the heights of humility, teaching us by your word, Father John Chrysostom, interceding for the word of Christ our God to save our soul. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You receive divine grace from heaven as Lord, we one by you. You teach all to worship one God in Trinity. Therefore, it is right to praise you, drawing to home now. You are a teacher revealing things divine. Now and ever through the ages of ages. Amen. Like a cloud rising over the company of the church, O all pure, and you prepared a hold on a royal city, but as the protection and champion of your people, protect from every affliction us who cry to you. Hail, protection, holy light. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Lord, to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages. Amen. For honorable than the children, the uncomparable voice of the seraphim, you adopt and complicate birth to God, Lord, true birth, dear birth, God, you magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
May God be gracious to us and bless us, may God His face shine upon us and have mercy on us.
Amen.
Glory to the God, and our glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Father, give the blessing.
May He. May He who is wanderers among the saints, Christ, the true God, through the intercession of His most spotless and most pure Holy Mother, the Holy Glories of Christ, the Apostle, the Glories of the Martyrs, and the Venerable God, and the Son of Fathers, the Holy Righteous Ancestors and Graduate of Kimanana, our Father among the Saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, the liturgy we celebrate the Holy, and of all the saints of mercy, constantly save us through the universal God of us, our God. Through the prayers of our Holy Father,
Amen.